There's always that one nightmare scenario that creeps the heck out of you. For some people, it's being sealed inside an elevator. The usual story is you get inside an elevator, it starts moving up, and after a few floors, it jutters for a moment and then stops. A moment later, the frayed cable snaps and you start to plummet uncontrollably. What's the first thing that crosses your mind? Can you actually save yourself from inevitable death by jumping at the right moment? Before we get to whether that's possible or not, consider jumping down to like the video and subscribe to the channel for more awesome content. Jumping at the right moment. By now, you must know that while the elevator is falling, you're falling along with it and there is nothing you can do about it. This means that when the elevator hits the base of the elevator shaft, your body will hit the base with it. Do you think that jumping at the right moment would help? Let's imagine a camera is placed inside the elevator so it can fall with you. Watching the final moments in slow motion, the elevator starts to descend rapidly and just before it hits the base, you jump up. At this moment, the camera sees you moving upwards with your own jump speed. The elevator is falling down with a certain speed we'll call elevator speed. Now, because you jumped at the same moment the elevator hit the base, you're falling a bit slower than the elevator. The speed at which you hit the floor is equal to the elevator speed minus your jump speed. It depends on how far you fall. Let's think in terms of height for a moment. How high was the elevator before its descent? And how high can you jump? Just for the sake of the experiment, we'll say that you have a vertical leap of 27.5 inches, which is close to an NBA average of 28 inches. We'll run a few scenarios to see what would happen when you fall from different heights. One story high, 10 feet. If you time this right, you'll hit the ground as if you fell from 31.5 inches. However, you only have 0.8 seconds to react, so you need to be prepared. Falling from this height means you just have to dust yourself off, because you wouldn't really get hurt. Three stories high, 30 feet. Falling from a height of 30 feet and timing your jump right would feel as if you fell from 15.4 feet. You wouldn't exactly die, but you would probably break at least one leg, possibly both, depending on how you land. 5 stories high, 49 feet. At this height, you would hit the base of the elevator shaft as if you fell from 30 feet. You would have about 1.7 seconds to react, which makes the difference between getting out of the elevator alive or in a body bag. 7 stories high, 69 feet. Falling from this height, even if you time your jump perfectly, would equate to you falling from 45 feet. Unfortunately, you would have about 2 seconds for your life to flash before your eyes. In this scenario, you would definitely not make it out of the elevator alive. Some experiments suggest lying on the floor of the elevator because you can evenly distribute the force of the impact over your entire body, including your brain. It goes without saying that you should not do this if you want to stay alive. Yes, your body would absorb the impact, but head injuries are the primary culprit in elevator accidents, so think twice before you hit the ground. A few scientific assumptions. The previously mentioned scenarios included perfect timing, which is probably not something you could easily pull off. At least not without seeing the ground with your own eyes so you can react accordingly. Some people have survived elevator falls because of the cables at the bottom of the shaft that softened the impact, but those cases are quite rare. In reality, modern elevators have plenty of backups that would prevent them from falling, such as electromagnetic brakes and multiple cables for additional support. But if you do end up in a falling elevator, go ahead and jump. You have nothing to lose.